and Doctor Who's Matt Smith and Karen Gillan will be here. Karen's she's getting herself dressed, looking beautiful. Matt's all ready to rock and roll. You're all ready, yes. We'll talk to them after the break. It's Harry Potter week here on Daybreak, and after the break, we'll be launching it with some of our own magic.
And we'll be introducing you to a very cleverly entitled Potter's Wheel. Who better to spin it than Doctor Who himself? It's Doctor Who himself. Matt Smith is here.
Hello, Matt.
Hello.
I'm going to squish in here
beside
you.
Give it a
spin. OK, Matt.
Right.
Not too hard, because we're running out of time.
Okay.
So just do it slow.
That's
it.
Yeah, that's it.
Good spin. That's a good spin.
Good spin action.
Good
spin.
Gentle-ish.
Good spin.
And it's going to land on Rupert.
Oh, there he is. OK.
Yeah.
Here's the clip.
We're just pressing some buttons. Here it is.
What's it like stepping out of the car and walking down the street out there?
Amazing. I'm so nervous and scared.
Really?
Yeah.
More nervous than you were when you went on set for the first time?
Probably, yeah, just as nervous as then.
What's the whole experience been like for you?
Amazing. It's been so great. It's been incredible.
Oh, on the red carpet, he's great, isn't he? You've something to say, Ben?
That was cool.
Now go to school.
Oh, nice. Lovely. We're loving Harry Potter week already, aren't we?
Let's have the weather now. I'm afraid it's very kirsty out there this morning.
And take a look at the best green room in the country at this very moment. Matt Smith and Karen Gillan. Oh, look at hello.
Yeah.
We're making stuff with Lego.
Oh, good for you.
She's finally ready.
And Tracy from X Factor. She's all smiles this morning.
Yeah.
Tracy's there, she is, looking great
what
this morning.
We'll be talking to all three shortly.
There's excitement in the air today. Yeah. Ladies and gentlemen, Matt Smith and Karen Gillan. Oh, look, you've even got, music. Look at that.
Matt, you are revered, and you are revered even more and adored, Karen, by everyone. The excitement generated by you turning up, it's incredible. Do you ever go to the shops anymore, just without being followed by 20 children?
It depends. Kind of if they're just coming out of school or whatever, then it's quite manic sometimes.
Trickier.
But sometimes not at all.
Yeah.
So,
yeah. Have you come to terms with the rules? Because I'm sure before having taken them on, I know we've talked about this before, there's
that
sense
there
is a pressure, isn't there, let's face it.
Yeah, yeah, of course. There's an inherent pressure because they're sort of, I guess, quite iconic. But I don't know, we're kind of locked away shooting most of the time, so we don't really think about it. It's fine. It's fun.
You talk to people who their favourite Doctor Who was. It dates them, doesn't it? So if I would say Tom Baker, then obviously it makes me of a certain age.
It places you in a certain era.
But 20, it's like Blue Peter presenters have the same kind of affair. Your favourite Blue Peter presenter was. But you are in 25 years' time. People will still say you too, won't they?
That's one of the lovely
that's
things,
nice.
Actually. That's one of the
and
nicest things,
yeah,
isn't it?
Yeah, that's
that
really nice.
To be
a part of sci-fi history.
Yeah, it's like I met Lottie this morning, your daughter, and it's nice to think
That's my daughter's friend, actually. She's. I heard that she's. They're absolutely. They're absolutely obsessed. I heard them talking to each other. And one of them said to the other, "I wonder if Karen Gillan likes Nutella."
And you.
That's what people are wondering.
I love Nutella.
You do like
on
Nutella.
Toast.
There you
on
go,
toast.
Girls.
Okay. Right. Now you know.
Yeah.
Okay.
So the new DVD is coming out now for Christmas, of course.
Today,
so
is that today?
Yeah. So it'll be the Christmas present of choice, I'm sure, for everybody, won't it? But we've got a little clip of the two of you together, and I think it has a lot to do with your chemistry, to be fair, which is why it's worked so well on this series. But you can decide for yourselves. Bit of an awkward moment there, obviously.
Everyone just went,
But it does make a difference getting along, doesn't it, when you're working so closely. We know ourselves.
You know, that
you have ups and downs.
Well, for sure, I know.
We do.
Yeah.
Maybe not you two. You look much more, much
you
more
will in time. Give it a couple of years.
I know. As age withers our relationship.
Yeah. That's what happened to us.
when you first got together, could you feel that it was going to be right, or is it a gradual thing?
I think there was something there when I auditioned with you.
Yeah,
something
you came
quite
in
sparky.
In a red coat, and I thought she was mad. She had this red coat on and all this red hair, which then was down to beyond her nether regions, yeah. as it were. And it was really long, and I thought, that's quite odd.
Yeah, it was quite odd.
And then I think we evolved in the first couple of months, though,
yeah,
didn't we?
Yeah, yeah. It's always going to develop, though, when you're working with someone so much, and it just changes.
And now we're really cooking, though, aren't we? It's fun. Well, I mean, you know, we have a right laugh.
Of course you do.
At work. It's very
really
funny.
Cooking in America as well. I mean, it's just really kicked off over
that's
there,
the plan,
hasn't it?
Yeah.
Yes.
Getting ready to see
it's going quite well.
Yeah,
yeah, it is, it is, it is. It's a...
And
exciting.
Once it kind of bites, it takes over, doesn't it? That's kind of the strength of Doctor Who.
Mm. I think so. It draws you in, doesn't it? It's
yeah.
like any good box set, really, like The Wire or The Sopranos. I mean, it's different, obviously, but it's there's a sort of...
You just become a part of it, don't you?
Yeah, a part of the world that is Doctor Who.
We went in search of the dolls yesterday.
Oh, yeah?
With two gorgeous little ones of Matt. Yeah. See those?
Do you think it looks like me?
Look at that.
I think it's good.
It kind of does,
yeah,
actually.
Oh, good.
That one there, maybe a little bit more. Yeah, I quite like those.
I'm afraid, though... Amy Pond, absolutely rank sold out. You couldn't even buy one yourself, I'm afraid.
Oh,
we
well,
just
can't, that's good.
Can't get one.
Oh, so mine are readily available and Karen's are sold out.
You probably made more of yours,
oh,
to be
that's,
fair.
They, oh, no.
I've got a number of quick fire questions for you. Who gets the most fan mail out of the two of you?
I don't know.
We don't actually...
My Munda's mine.
Yes,
we don't compare.
Patrick's Munda's yours.
Yeah.
Maybe they should, yeah.
Maybe that, they should compare.
Who knows?
Who's the geekiest?
Me.
Yeah.
Geekiest.
Well, quite cheeky, that one. I'm not asking that one.
Who is the best kisser?
Yeah.
How do you compare that one?
I don't know.
Don't do it now. That'll be embarrassing if
you get in trouble.
I'm going to say...
Me.
Like you?
Yeah.
All right, Matt. Confident me.
Yeah. Great to see you both.
Yeah,
stay with us if you can.
Exactly. And the DVD is out, as you say, today.
Yeah. It is, exactly.
Today.
Yeah, yeah. It's going to be cool.
Good stuff. It looks
still
good.
To come on Daybreak, it's all the news, travel and weather where you are.
And we'll be joined by Treyc. Were the X Factor judges right to let her go? We'll be putting that question to her afterwards.
That's all after your chance to shake off the winter blues in style.
Welcome back to Daybreak. Treyc's here this morning with us. Morning, Treyc. Yeah. It's been sort of a crazy 12 hours for you so far, hasn't it?
Yeah, mad. But I'm still awake, that's the main thing.
No, you're doing well. I mean, it is the talk of the town this morning and the papers, of course, as well. Cheryl Cole last night. Did you watch it yourselves last night?
I missed it.
I heard on the radio
I'm
that
going
she
mad.
Abstained her vote or something, right?
Yes,
she
couldn't decide. Between her two girls. Okay. Let's remind ourselves,
yeah,
actually, for your benefit,
this
Karen.
You.
But Dermot was trying to make clear that she had two, but then she decided not to, and all the rest of it. I mean, how do you feel about how that went? It seemed a little bit of an awkward moment, really.
If I was in her position, I don't think I could have chose between two acts that she was mentoring. I don't think it would have been fair to the other act. Hi.
I know she did want it to go to deadlock, basically, and allow the public, which would have been, I suppose, fair by any counts, which would have meant that you could quite possibly still be
could possibly
in the running
still
this
been
morning.
There. But everything happens for a reason. I'm a great believer in what will be, will be.
Mm-hmm.
I really don't feel like it's going to be the end for me.
And even just, it's just a matter of hours after performing this and looking back, were you happy with what you did over the weekend?
Oh, God, yeah. I felt like a princess on Saturday night. I think it's the best I've looked on the show.
Mm-hmm.
I really enjoyed my performance, loved the song. I thought I really did a good job, but possibly the audience possibly just didn't.
Because the week before, I think it was Simon had said that he thought you were sort of lacking the passion, although you came back and said you were feeling it, you just weren't quite showing it. So do you think that you did deliver on that kind of
thing? I definitely think I put my all into that performance. I really enjoyed it. I came off stage happy, and I came off stage pleased, and I was really happy.
Mm-hmm. So what advice would you have for Treyc now? Because you've got to take knocks in this business, haven't you? Nobody who got anywhere did so without having any knocks.
Mm-hmm.
What would you say, Karen?
Keep going.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't feel in the position to really dish out advice on this, but keep singing because I really like your voice.
Yeah. Oh, thank you.
I do.
Thank you very much.
And what a wonderful experience you've had.
Yeah.
What a wonderful journey.
Absolutely
you've been on,
amazing. It's been a blessing. I've really thoroughly enjoyed it, and I've learned a lot about myself. And I just want to, grab this opportunity with both hands and just continue to push myself and get out there.
Go
and
on,
what about getting back to normal life? No disrespect to Tamworth. But, in a couple of months' time, having performed to 12 million people, wherever it was, suddenly you'll be shopping in Tamworth, which is fine.
Yeah.
As shopping experiences go. But are you ready for that?
I am ready. I am ready, but, you know, it's going to be a challenge. But I want to sing, and I want to make myself better, and I want to be successful. So I possibly might not. I'll go back home to see my friends and family who I've missed immensely. Yeah. But I am planning on staying in London and working on the singing career, because that's what I want to do.
All right, well, Treyc.
And no, just quick, what sort of help do they give you off the back of it? Obviously, you've been thrown into this crazy bubble, and then suddenly it's like, OK, bye-bye. I mean, is there, you nearly need counselling after it, don't you?
Yeah. Counselling, did you say?
Yeah. in a very positive way, yeah. I mean, of course. Yeah. But, you know, it is a strange...
Yeah, we've got help on hand, but I'm a strong person. I'm going to be fine. Mm. But there are people that are... ready to help me.
Yeah. Well, Treyc, you were great. I loved you this weekend. And as you said, I thought
you
looked fantastic as well.
Okay. Thank you.
Great things to come for
Treyc. Do join us after the break.
Yes, we've got loads of emails today about celebrity friends and who you maybe have on your Facebook. And just a reminder, you can join us on our Facebook page as well. But just very briefly, I love this one. This is from Liam. Lionel Blair's dad used to cut my hair.
Yeah.
Oh, there's a link.
I had a lift home with Bill Wyman and his wife back in 1965 in Winchester. Okay. Still grateful.
Oh,
yes.
And this is Amanda. When I go home to Dundee, I often see Lorraine Kelly on my flight.
It's a straightforward lie. She's got a private jet revving up out there. Thank you all for coming in.
Thank you all. Good luck, Treyc.
Join us tomorrow. Have a good day.
Bye-bye.